3 years after the Supreme Court's decision in Brown v. Board of Education, which outlawed segregated schools, there still were not any classrooms in the Deep South where blacks and whites sat together. At Central High School in Little Rock, Arkansas, not one black child had ever enrolled before 1957, when 9 black students were selected to integrate it. 15-year-old Melba Petillo was one of the 9.
I understood education before I understood anything else. From the time I was 2, my mother said, education is your key to survival.
But instead of helping, Arkansas Governor Orville Faubus called in the state militia and ordered them to keep the 9 students out of Central High.
It is my conviction that it will not be possible to restore or to maintain order if forcible integration is carried out in the schools of this community.
In response to the governor's defiance, a federal court ordered desegregation to proceed in Little Rock. September 23rd was to be the first day of integration. That morning, a large group of angry citizens assembled outside Central High School.
On the car radio, I could hear that there was a mob. I knew that the sounds that came from the crowd were very angry. So we entered the side of the building very, very fast. Even as we entered, there were people running after us, people tripping other people.
With the mob vowing to lynch the 9 black students, local police stepped in and removed them from the building. Integration in Little Rock had lasted just part of a morning. In response, Little Rock's mayor made a plea for help to President Dwight D. Eisenhower.
President Eisenhower was not that interested in civil rights by and large. But once courts began ordering school desegregation, it was the obligation of the president to enforce the law. Eisenhower had no choice, and it was a very important symbolic act because it showed that the power of the federal government would be behind the desegregation orders which were coming down from courts, and that Southern whites who thought they could resist would not only be resisting individual people, but would be resisting the force of the federal government.
Mob rule cannot be allowed to override the decisions of our courts.
On September 24th, under the protection of the U.S. military, the 9 black students were escorted to Central High School. Among them was Ernest Green. A military convoy took him to school that day.
The whole school was ringed with paratroopers and helicopters hovering around. We marched up the steps with this circle of soldiers with bayonets drawn. Walking up the steps that day was probably one of the biggest feelings I've ever had.
That year, Ernest became the first black person to graduate from Central High.
I knew that once I got as far as that principal and received that diploma, I had cracked the wall.